Welcome to No Tooth Tony Interviews. The purpose of this channel is to give women a chance to share their voice without any judgment. Please respect all of the guests featured on my show. Thank you for watching. I hope you have a great day. All right, so today we have Miss Sharon and Mr. Grandson, and they are two new guests on my show. Today I'm using Omegle. I know this is different, but hey, it's gonna have to work. It's all we got right now. So yeah, Miss Sharon, it's an honor to have you here on my show. Thank you for all of the positivity that you and Grandson showed me thus far. I really do appreciate it. It's an honor to have you here.
Well, let me tell you that if I didn't have God in my life, I would be very, very unhappy, because God has gotten me walking after 11 strokes. So, and I didn't die. I'm still here. So God is good all the time. And don't forget it. He's in charge. Don't be impatient with him. Wait on him. And he'll help you out. Like, I'm walking, and I didn't think, I knew I would. I said I was going to walk again.
Yes,
and
ma'am.
Now I am.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
I'm slow. But I get there.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. It's okay. As long as you get there, that's all that matters.
That's all that matters.
Miss Sharon, what's your zodiac sign?
Scorpio.
What do they say about Scorpios?
We're water babies. I'm dangerous. I love life. And I love adventure. I'm a motorcycle rider, or was.
What?
And I rode my motorcycle in a group, and we went from here to other states and back. We traveled all over Texas.
Man.
And I loved it. I taught my son how to ride a dirt bike, and we went dirt bike riding a lot when he was younger. So, like I said, I love adventure.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. That's awesome. My next question for you is, what's your favorite color?
Blue.
Has blue.
Shades of blue.
Yes, ma'am. Has blue always been your favorite color?
In fact, my euphonium, I had to get a plastic euphonium because I couldn't hold my brass euphonium anymore, because it was too heavy because of the strokes. It was too heavy for me, so I ordered and got a blue euphonium.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. What all other instruments do you play?
I used to play clarinet and saxophone, tenor saxophone, in high school. And French horn. And trumpet.
Yes, ma'am. Yes,
and I switched from trumpet to euphonium because I love that low brass feel you get. I like that low brass.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. My next question for you is, what are your five favorite foods?
Peanut butter, spaghetti, and tacos.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. Peanut butter, spaghetti, and tacos, for sure. If you could visit five countries, where would you go?
I go to Australia, Ireland. I've already been to England and Scotland. I have relatives there in Rosyth, Scotland. And I'd go to, I think I would visit Russia. I would love to see Russia. I love the architecture, the way their buildings all look. It's beautiful.
Yes, ma'am. I agree. My next question for you is, would you rather go would you rather go into space or deep sea diving?
Deep sea diving.
What would you like?
I used to scuba dive.
No way.
Yes.
What?
When I was lived in California.
Yeah.
Yes. I learned how to scuba dive.
What? How was it?
It's fun. Man. California is hard because it's just, when you get down into the water, it's so sandy that you get claustrophobic. You feel like you're being boxed in. It's an interesting feeling. I didn't think I'd ever feel claustrophobic.
Yes, ma'am.
I'm not normally. I love open space. I love to hike. I used to take my kids hiking all the time. We'd go and we'd go hiking in the woods, and we'd find old farms, and we'd go look at the old farms. We'd go through the buildings, and then I'd take pictures of the kids in different kinds of clothes in a farmhouse.
Yes, ma'am.
And I love to do things like that. I love, like I say, I love adventure. I love new things.
Yes,
I love to explore.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. What have been some cool things that you've seen underwater?
Stingrays, some coral underwater, and big shells, the big shells that you see.
Mm-hmm.
In fact, I brought some home.
For real? That's cool. That's cool right there. What are your five favorite animals?
Dogs, cats, elephants. I collect elephants.
Yes, man. That's awesome. My great grandma, she collect elephants too. And she made puzzles. She made puzzles with elephants.
Did she?
Oh, yes, ma'am.
That's cool.
What are your five favorite drinks?
Pepsi. Hot tea of different flavors. I love to try different flavors of hot tea. I love chai tea the best.
Mm-hmm. Yes, ma'am. Do you like to go shopping?
Don't have the money for it.
I understand. Me
either.
I don't
like the window shop. I like to go to, we have a couple of malls here that you can just walk through, walk around. And I love to look in all the different shops to see what kind of things they have. I love electronics. I like pocket games. I love games.
Yeah.
My kids grew up playing games. My grandkids play games. We play games together. In fact, my family used to have a game night once a week, once a month. And we get together and just play games.
That's awesome. That's awesome. Can you play checkers?
Yes.
Can you play chess?
No. I never learned.
Can you play 21 or blackjack?
Yes.
Can you play goldfish?
Yes.
Can you play spades?
Yes.
What? You play spades?
Yeah. In fact, I play spades on my phone.
Okay. Okay. So, all right. So, whenever you play in person, what suits do you go? How you play? Like, all right, so where I'm from, we play the Joker, the two of spade, and then the ace of spade. Is that how you play or no?
Yes.
Yes, man. Joker, Joker, dude's ace. Yeah, we could play. You'd be on my team, dog. I'll play with you. I'll play with you one time, dog. We'll run a game one day, Miss Sharon, for sure. You ever run to Boston?
Okay.
Have you ever run to Boston?
I have not ever. I want to. That's one of the places I'd love to go visit.
Yes, ma'am.
I have such... In 03 and 07, in that era, I would go out and take pictures, and then I would write poetry to the pictures.
Yes,
and
ma'am.
One of the things I did, I went to West Virginia, and I took pictures of a bay area that had all these boats in it.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
It was beautiful.
That's awesome.
I just can't imagine where people would go.
Yes, ma'am. It's very beautiful there. Do you have any talents, any special talents?
Music, playing handbells at church.
Yes, ma'am.
Playing in a band.
Do you sing too?
I sing in the choir, although my stroke has taken away my singing ability for now. I'm working to get it back.
Yes, ma'am. Well, look, take your time. Don't be in no rush. It's going to come.
Not.
Don't be in no rush.
I'm not.
One day at a time.
I was in a rush to, you want to hear a funny story?
Oh, man, let me hear it.
When they put me in a rehab place, I would dream and that I could just get up and walk. And so in the middle of the night, I'd get up and try to walk, and they'd always find me on the floor somewhere.
Yeah.
And then my left hand was paralyzed, and still I'm working on it. It's still not working right. And it has a mind of its own. And this is the story. I was drinking hot coffee in bed at a rehab place, and my left hand decided to pour the coffee in my lap. So I started cursing my hand and hitting it and calling it names, and my daughter came in laughing, and I said, "What are you laughing about?" She said, "I never heard anybody call their hand a bitch before." I said, "Well, it poured hot coffee in my lap." And I happened to be watching a preacher on TV that day, and he said, if you have an affliction, which this is affliction, instead of cursing it, praise it, and God will use it for service. So I went to breakfast, and this is a story about guardian angels. We all have one, and I have proof. I went to breakfast, and my right hand was weak, or still kind of weak, because they don't work on the good hand. They only focus on the bad hand.
Right.
And so my right hand got weaker, and I was holding a glass of orange juice, and it was very heavy, and I thought it was going to drop. I was eating with some other ladies, and I thought I was going to drop it, and I felt this kind of push from the back. And I looked around, and there was not anybody there. And all of a sudden, my hand got lighter, and I looked down, and my left hand had gotten into a fist and got underneath that glass and was helping me go to the right of my breakfast tray and put it down. God used my hand.
Yes, ma'am.
Instead of cursing it, praise it. Praise your affliction, and God will use it to good service. And he used it that day, and I knew that right then that God, I had a guardian angel sitting on my shoulder, and God was with me.
Yes, ma'am.
He never left me.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
And that was my proof right there.
Yes, ma'am. My next question for you is, what is your message to the future generation of children?
I believe in God and Jesus Christ as your personal Savior, He will get you through the hardest times of your life. Right now, I'm struggling with the shot that they want to give everybody.
Uh-huh.
I'm more afraid of the shot than I am the virus that's going around. I mean, God got me through 11 strokes, and I didn't die. I had a heart attack in 03, and I didn't die. I'm not afraid of the virus or the flu or whatever it is that's going around, because I know that God is there, and He's going to protect me no matter what. He's there. He's my shield, and He's my armor. He's the one that gets me through every day. He's the one that got me walking. And it was tough because my balance is way, way off. My grandkids can tell you that. My grandson is the one that picks me up off the floor when I fall. He's a strong boy.
Yes,
ma'am. I appreciate him and love him so much because he has picked me up so many times off the floor. I can't tell you. I don't know what I'd do without him. He and my daughter take care of me, and it's hard. You know, my daughter does all the work in the house. She's sick right now. She's got her head cold. But, you know, God gets us through all the hard times. We have to believe that. If we don't, we're done for. This earth was, you know, we got to take care of the earth. God gave us the earth. It's our garden of Eden. All the trees and all the beautiful flowers. I was thinking of that today because I was going through some old cards I had made. I told you I take pictures and write poetry to the pictures. And I was looking at some flowers that I had taken pictures of. And He's given us all this beautiful stuff. And what do we do with it? We destroy it. We've got to take care of the earth. We have to.
Yes, ma'am. We got to.
You know, God gives us our children. We take care of our children. So why don't we take care of the earth that God gave us? Be thoughtful in what you do. Be mindful of what you do.
Yes, ma'am.
Absolutely. And believe. Always believe.
Yes, ma'am. What would you like people to know about you?
I enjoy life. Despite the fact that I've had 11 strokes, I still love life. I love my music. You can ask my grandkids. I have an Excel, and I play music on it all the time. I mean, Alexa. And I play music on it constantly.
Yeah. That's
I love it. I love music. All kinds. I'm not real picky. I love classical. I've played classical. I love modern hymns. I've just discovered that one. And it's beautiful music. I love minor tones. And I hope people know what minor tones are. They may not. But you hear them. But in modern hymns, there's a lot of minor tones, just like there is in Celtic music. There's a lot of minor tones. I love Celtic music, too. I just love music.
Yes,
it soothes my soul. It calms me down. If I'm upset or anxious about something, God's music calms me, calms my soul, and it gets me through whatever I'm going through. And it helps me to go to sleep at night. I wake up to it in the morning, so I'm surrounded with God's music all the time. And it, if when I die, that's what I want my grandkids to remember about me, is how I loved my music.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. Well, Miss Sharon, I would like to tell you thank you so much for coming on my show. Is there anything that I didn't ask you, or is there anything that we didn't talk about that you would like to say?
If there's something you want to do and you're afraid to do it, get out there and do it. Like riding a motorcycle or rappelling. Rappelling is so much fun. And riding a motorcycle is so much fun. It's like scuba diving. It puts you in a different world. It's quiet. And, you know, it's a mindset.
Yeah.
I don't know if people understand that, but it just, because you're out there in the open, you're in the open and you're going down the road and you're looking at, you can smell things more when you're on a motorcycle. When you go through a tree, you can smell the water. When you go over a dam or over a lake or a creek, you can smell the water before you even get there. And that's what I love about motorcycle riding. I also did distant biking, bicycling, when I was younger. Right now I'm 76. But when I was younger, I would get up early in the morning. My mother lived about 15 miles away from me before she passed away. And I would get up early in the morning in the summer, and I would ride to my mother's house, to her apartment, mm-hmm. eat breakfast, visit, and then I would ride back home. And again, it just, you know, my uncle got me into motor. My uncle lived in Denver, Colorado. And I have pictures of me when I was little trying to trade my tricycle for his motorcycle.
Yeah, that's a fair trade.
Yeah, I thought so. He was a little big to ride a tricycle. And I was a little small to ride a motorcycle. But
yes, ma'am.
I tried.
That's awesome.
I made up for it later.
Yes, ma'am. Well, Miss Sharon, thank you. Thank you. Thank you for coming on my show.
Yeah, and I love camping.
Camping. Love camping.
Yes. The best times I had was when my mother was alive, and I took my kids and we all drove to Colorado to a Christian camp there, and we camped in the woods next to a creek, it was like a river. And during the night, you could hear all these animals going around and scourging and trying to get your food and things. But you know, we had horses going by us and stuff all night long. But it was great. I love camping.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. Thank you again, Miss Sharon.